All right, so now the car's been case swapped. The next thing is to get the diff in. So obviously drive shaft to go here, run through the floor. We're gonna have to get rid of this or some of it. And then we're gonna have to cut this part of the floor out. I've roughly marked, you know, just to give an idea. And then we're gonna mount the diff. So the diff will be able to mount to the floor here, mount to this probably as well. And yeah, it's pretty straightforward. We've had to remove the fuel tank though, because in the Civic, the fuel tank is right here. Video 2 for the Civic. Week 2. And we have the diff all mounted. CV shafts in. So we use two left hand CRV mounts. CV shafts, sorry. Obviously that's the CRV diff, rear diff. We made the mount. It's pretty normal to what we made before, I guess. Just bolts to the top of the diff. The two bolts are already there, or two bolt holes are already in the casting. And then bolts through the floor with those four bolts. I'll take it down and show you what we did in the boot. But yeah, that's it. So that's the brake setup and the rear control arms, I guess. I'm going to make a mount for the sway bar. The original CRV sway bar is going to bolt onto here. I'll have a look at its movement, but I'm pretty sure it's going to clear the floor, so we'll be able to have a rear sway bar mounted as well. We'd already been over that we used the standard brake lines. I think we do have to cut this L shaft, but we'll find that out when we cut this floor, which we're about to do. Take it down off the hoist, pull the interior out of it, and then cut this floor. I think we only have to cut back to here, I think, just there where that sort of crease is. And obviously we'll take that out because the tail shaft has to pass through it. Center bearing ends up here somewhere, I think, but we'll work that out later. Yeah, and then I don't know if we're gonna, it's gonna be a bit of a tight squeeze with the thick CRV sway bar because of the 3-inch exhaust is going to have to come through here beside the tail shaft. So hoping to get at least get the tail shaft bolted on before I attempt to adapt the old CRV 3-inch exhaust to fit through that gap and then run a long pass through here, run down the floor. It'll hang pretty low being a bit bigger diameter pipe as well, so just have to, the car's not going to be low, so it's not a big deal. We'll run one full size muffler in here and then one full size muffler at the rear in this gap. But yeah, that's it. I'm going to take it down, get the interior out, like I said, and start cutting it up. That's where we're at. Oh, hang on, I'll show you the boot first. All right, so that's where the mount comes through in the back floor, in the boot here. So I've used a fairly thick plate for the bracket. But in here, we've just used another bit of body metal to distribute that weight, that load, and not pull through this, because this is a pretty thin floor. And then it's just on there, bolted through. It's just there, like I said, to distribute the weight over the sheet metal. It is just another bit of sheet metal, a little bit thicker than the body of the Civic there, because that's really thin where it's been pressed and stretched. So it's a little bit thicker, but it'll just distribute the weight of that solid, or that hard steel mount. It's pretty hard and thick steel, you know, it's just a bit of plate, so you don't want it to tear through the floor and pull the metal through with it. We'll probably tighten it up a bit more, but for now that's in there, that's how it's going to be. And it'll work, and then eventually we'll get this foot sorted out and strip out all this dead weight and get rid of those speakers. They look heavy, maybe a couple of kilos in those bad boys. Probably 500 grams, so I'm joking, but anyway, all this stuff can go, all this crap that we don't need. Yeah. Alright, I'm going to get the interior stripped out, and then we'll get back to it. Alright, so it's going to be a wrap today. I had just thought about cutting this out, and then I kind of looked at it, and with this, if you see these spot rivets here, they actually go to a little chassis that's two separate bits of chassis that run through the middle beside them, the big rails. So I decided to make a brace. Its angle, it's a bit overkill, but I had to make up the strength that I'm going to take out of this floor, which is double layered there and double layered over there. So that's the best I can come up with. So I've already welded that in, welded this in. So drive shaft is next. Got to get this floor out first. Diff's already mounted. Alright, so Civic going again. Managed to cut this gaping big hole in the floor. It's all sealed up. Probably gonna put some panels over here to cover up this mess. But I can't really do anything right now until we've got the tail shaft back from being modified so that we can make the center bearing. But yeah, it's a nice hole.